In his infancy, Natsu Dragneel was a pretty normal child living in a pretty normal village.
And then a bunch of dragons toasted the town and killed everybody, including him. The end.
Almost. Fortunately, Natsu's older brother, Zeref, survived. Horrified by the violent fate of his family, Zeref desperately sought a way to revive Natsu. Eventually, he discovered the connections between life, death, and magic, and became obsessed.
And so, he became the most evil and powerful mage ever, cursed to live forever and ruin everyone's lives. But everything worked out, I guess, because he brought Natsu back. Just one catch, Natsu had to be revived as a demon, though this gave him the potential to become even more powerful than Zeref.
Unfortunately, Zeref had become incredibly dangerous to be around. Fearing for his brother's safety, he left Natsu in the care of his friend Igneel, who just so happened to be the Fire Dragon King.
Natsu got adopted by a freaking dragon. Kinda weird since the dragon killed him in the first place and his family, but whatever. Dragon Dad ended up teaching little Natsu Dragon Slayer magic, a school of mystical martial arts developed specifically to kill dragons. Wait, man, it's really back and forth with these dragons, isn't it?
Regardless, Igneel eagerly accepted his role as adoptive father. He taught Natsu how to read, write, and fight. But then when Natsu came of age, Igneel suddenly sent him through a time machine and poof! Before he knew it, Natsu was trapped 400 years in the future and abandoned by the only father figure he ever really knew.
I know that feel, little buddy. I know that feel.
Of course, it was all part of Igneel's plan to save the world, but at the time, Natsu didn't know that. Fortunately, it wasn't long before he found a new home and family among the mercenaries of the Fairy Tale Guild.
Yeah, turns out being a demon trained by a goddamn dragon made Natsu pretty effective as a bounty hunter.
Natsu possesses superhuman speed, impressive strength, and unbelievable durability. He has superior senses, such as sight and smell, along with a mastery of hand-to-hand combat skills.
Mix all that up with his fire dragon slayer magic, and you got one fiery cocktail that'll knock just about anybody on their ass.
As the name suggests, fire dragon slayer magic revolves around conjuring and manipulating fire. A prime example would be Natsu's signature move, the Fire Dragon's Roar,
where he literally shoots fire from his mouth.
Or he can engulf his hand in flames for the devastating Fire Dragon's Iron Fist.
You know, we're gonna be saying fire a lot this episode.
Fire! 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 Fire!
Yep. Natsu has well over 24 different ways to incorporate fire into his martial arts. But his real strength comes from a move nobody ever really expects.
Yeah. He eats fire!
The more fire he eats, the more powerful Natsu's magic becomes.
Are you kidding me? I've wanted to learn how to blow stuff up with magic forever, and all this time I just needed to eat some fire?
Boomstick, that's not how... You know what? Yes. Yes, that's exactly how it works.
Cool! Be right back, gonna go get a snack.
Okay then, have fun! Be sure to be here next week, we gotta cover Natsu's opponent, Ace.
I was up here! The alcohol, the flames won't go out!